President Yoweri Museveni has urged people to make use of village councils to access services. Museveni said this will make it possible for the community to ask for accountability for money spent on government programs such as the Parish Development Model, PDM, and MUGA. The president was speaking during the Thanksgiving service for the Minister of State for Foreign Affairs in charge of regional affairs, John Mulimba, in Busia. President Museveni urged all leaders to support government programs such as UP and USE. He raised concern over people who extort money from parents and pupils in UPE and USE schools.
I want you to support me in implementing free education completely free without charges in schools, government schools.
He said this initiative was meant to support the less privileged population in the country, Uganda.
I really want you to deal with the issue of homestead production. You must get involved in wealth creation.
Minister Mulimba thanked God for all his achievements in life. He also thanked President Museveni for entrusting him with the position of minister in his government. He promised to serve diligently. He revealed that a group of NUP supporters had crossed to the NRM party during the function. The Minister of State, Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development, Opoloto Kasai, has revealed that the government is not going to renew the Umeme contract after a contracted period elapses. Umeme formally received written communication from the government of the Republic of Uganda, notifying it that the current concession will continue to run until its natural end in March 2025, as stipulated in the concession agreements, after which there will be no renewal. Minister Okasai revealed this during the third annual manufacturers dialogue at Uma Hall in Kampala.
It is not the Catholic Church, the religious thing where we renew our vows because we have got to continue. This one was very clear, 20 years, the time is over.
Okasai said that the government is committed to investing more in the distribution of electricity to the most of the country. Minister Okasai has assured the employees of Umeme Company that the government has planned to move them to Uganda Electricity Distribution Company Limited, UEDCL, and promises better working terms.
When they get into Uganda Distribution Company, Electricity Distribution Company, the terms will even be better.
The minister spoke about this while meeting manufacturers in the third annual manufacturers dialogue, where they discussed the national budget 2024-2025 and its implications for the manufacturing sector. Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida has said he will step down in September, ending a three-year term marred by political scandals and paving way for a new premier to address the impact of rising prices. Kishida's decision to quit triggers a contest to replace him as president of the ruling Liberal Democratic Party, LDP, and an extension as the leader of the world's fourth biggest economy. Kishida helped transform Japan's foreign policy, boosting its global role and accelerating a major military expansion, despite facing domestic challenges that ultimately led to his exit. In an expected announcement on Wednesday, Kishida said he will not seek re-election as head of Japan's ruling Liberal Democratic Party, meaning he will step down as prime minister following an internal leadership election next month. In a press conference, Kishida emphasized the importance of public trust in politics, stating, "Politics cannot function without public trust. I made this heavy decision thinking of the public with a strong will to push political reform forward." The LDP is scheduled to hold a leadership election in September, where Kishida's successor will be chosen. The new leader will face the immediate challenge of restoring public confidence in the party while addressing critical issues such as inflation, geopolitical tensions, and the potential return of Donald Trump as US president. Kishida's popularity began to decline shortly after he assumed office in 2021, following revelations about LDP's connections to the controversial unification charge.